Böyle should be a problem at the link.
No problem. Yeah.
Is it
Yeah.
okay?
This is good.
Yes, it's fine.
It's okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Let me inform you that this is a multidisciplinary conference, and I am sure you agree with me that every scholar is not familiar every subject of the science. Therefore, at the beginning of my talk, I'll introduce the basic terms and definition related to the shape-memory alloy, shape-memory effect, and crystallographic transformation in shape-memory alloys. As you can see, the title of my presentation is Physicochemical Factor. This means physical and chemical factors and thermoresponsive reaction in shape-memory alloys. Metallic alloys have different phases at the different condition, and these phases are described in the phase diagram as alloy composition and temperature, or composition pressure dependent. Shape-memory alloys take place in the beta phase region with the alloy composition and exhibit a peculiar property called shape-memory effect. These alloys are very sensitive to temperature and other external condition, and crystal structures turn into the other structures with variation of temperature and stressing. Lattice vibration, phonons, atomic bonds, internal friction, and interatomic interaction play an important role in the processing of transformation. These physical and chemical factors are described by potential functions between atom pairs, pairwise potential function, and embedded electron cloud potential interaction. Shape-memory alloys are thermoresponsive materials and exhibit a peculiar property called shape-memory effect. This behavior is initiated by cooling and deformation process and perform thermal on heating and cooling processes. These alloys can be plastically deformed in the low temperature condition and recover the original shape just by thermal means on heating or the reverse transition temperature after removing the external strain. These materials cycle between the deformed and original shapes on cooling and heating. Shape-memory alloys exhibit another property called ferroelasticity, which is performed by mechanical stresses in a constant temperature. Therefore, these alloys exhibit dual thermoelastic and superelastic characteristics in memory manner. This is a basic illustration of shape-memory effect and superelasticity. Shape-memory effect is also called thermal memory, and as I mentioned, in the shape-memory effect, the material is deformed in the low temperature condition in the martensitic state. This is plastic deformation, and after releasing, the material keeps the deformed shape due to the plastic deformation. On heating, material recovers the original shape, and the shape of material cycle between original and deformed shape on heating and cooling. In the superelasticity, material is stressed in the parenthesis region, and after releasing, the material recovers the original shape by exhibiting classical elastic material behavior. Shape-memory effect and superelasticity is result of the crystallographic transformations, thermal and stress-induced martensitic transformations, and evaluated by structural change in atomic scale. Shape memory effects is performed thermally in a temperature interval depending on the forward austenite martensite and reverse martensite austenite transformation on cooling and heating. Superelasticity is performed in the parent austenite phase region just above the austenite finish temperatures. In the superelasticity, the materials are stressed in the parent phase region and shape recovery is performed instantaneously and simultaneously upon releasing the applied stress. This is temperature hysteresis of shape memory effect. The crystallographic transformation, which is thermal induced martensitic transformations, are isothermal transformations, and martensitic transformations start at MS temperatures on cooling and completed at AMF temperatures. Less temperatures are martensitic start and martensitic finish temperatures. On heating, reverse austenitic transformations start at AS temperatures and completed AF temperatures. And over the AF temperature, the material is in the complete parenthetic region. This is stress-strain characteristic in shape memory effect and superelasticity. As I mentioned, in the shape memory effect, the materials deformed in the low temperature condition. Excuse me, is it okay?
Yes, doctor, you can go ahead.
Yeah, yeah, okay, thank you very much. The material is deformed in the parent phase region, which is plastic deformation. And as you can see, early stage of deformation in both shape memory effect and superelasticity exhibit elementary elastic material behavior. In the shape memory effect, stress-induced martensitic transformation occurs in the plateau level. Also, stress-induced martensitic transformations occur in the plateau level in the superelasticity. Upon releasing, the material keeps the deformed shape in the shape memory effect, and on heating, recover the original shape and cycle between original and deformed shape on heating and cooling. As you can see, in the superelasticity, stressing and releasing paths are different, and this hysteresis loop refers to the energy dissipation. Excuse me, I think there should be a problem.
What happened, doctor? We can able to hear you. Your voice is not coming.
I think yeah, I cannot open the next slide. Yeah. This is stress-strain behavior of shape memory alloys at different temperatures between martensitic finish and austenitic start temperatures. As you can see, stress-strain behavior exhibit different behaviors beyond shape memory effect and superelasticity. As I mentioned, shape memory behavior is evaluated by the microstructural change in atomic scale or Armstrong level caused by the internal stresses, whereas shape change occurs in the macro level. Thermal induced martensitic transformations occur in the material in thermal manners on cooling from high temperature parent phase region, and it's characterized by change in the crystal structures of material. Martensitic transformations are lattice distortion fast transformations and occur as twinned martensite with the cooperative movement of atoms over very short distances on the order of Armstrong by means of shear-like mechanism. Twinned martensitic structures turn into the detwinned martensite or reoriented martensite by means of Strain induced monocytic transformation applying external stresses. This is the thematic or shape memory effect in the crystallographic level. Let me inform you that monocytic transformation and shape memory effect is observed in the metaphase region of material, and ordered structure is essential for shape memory effect. The first step in the transformation is cooling, and on cooling, ordered parent phase structures turn into the twinned monocytic structures by means of thermal induced monocytic transformation. And with the deformation in the low temperature condition, twinned monocytic structures turn into the detwinned monocytic structures by means of stress induced monocytic transformation. After this treatment on heating, detwinned monocytic structures turn into the austenitic structures by means of reverse austenitic transformation, and crystal structures cycle between ordered parent phase structures and detwinned monocytic structures on heating and cooling. In the superelasticity, the material is deformed in the parent phase region, and ordered parent phase region turn into the detwinned monocytic structures by means of stress-induced monocytic transformation. You find releasing detwinned monocytic structures turn into the ordered parent phase structures by exhibiting elementary elastic material behavior. As I mentioned, superelasticity is also linked with stress-induced monocytic transformation, which is induced by applying all the mechanical stresses, and with this stress, parent austenitic phase structures turn into the completed detwinned monocytic structures, as in the deformation step of shape memory effect, and twinned monocytic structures turn into the parent phase structures upon releasing external stress. The crystal structures also cycle between parent phase structures and detwinned monocytic structures on stressing and releasing. Let me inform you that stress strain curve exhibit nonlinear behavior, and stressing and releasing paths are different, and hysteresis loops refers to the energy dissipation. This is stress strain characteristics in the superelasticity, and with the stressing, ordered parent phase structures turn into the detwinned monocytic structures by means of stress-induced monocytic transformation. Monocytic transformation is a first-order solid-state fast transition and occurs in a few steps with the cooperative movement of atoms in dispersive manner. Therefore, these transitions have diffusionless character and product monocytic phase inherits the order of parent austenitic phase. Monocytic transformation mainly occurs into basic step in the beta phase region of material. These are vein distortion and lattice invariant shapes. As I mentioned, shape memory effect is observed in the beta phase region, and these are represent different unit cell. This is a basic bodycentric cubic unit cell. This is cesium chloride type unit cell. This is deuterate type unit cell. The last one is L21 type unit cell, or half of the unit cell. Vein distortion is mainly effective in ternary coupled vein shape momentalis and consists of an expansion of 26% in one of the O1 type axis called vein axis, and a compression of 11% in the other O1 type direction perpendicular to the vein axis. There are three main axes. There's a cube axis, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, and BCC-based unit cells turn into the BCT structures as a trivariant at the different orientation. Lattice invariant shares occur as Martens trivariants on one monotype planes of austenitic matrix, which is basal plane of martensite. Their shares occurs into opposite direction, one monotype direction on the one monotype planes. The one plane family represents 613 planes and totally 24 martensite variants occurs. These planes are listed as follow: 110, minus 110, 101, minus 101, 011, 01, minus 1. Lattice invariant shear and lattice twinning is not uniform in coupled-based shape over always, and their shares cause to the formation of layered structures. One monotype planes of parent phase turn into the unusual layer structures, which consist of an array of closed packet planes with complicated significant sequences called as 3R, 9R, or 18R martensite, depending on the significant sequences on the closed packet planes of the ordered lattice. The periodicity and therefore the unit cell is completed through 18 layers in directions that in case of 18R martensite structures. This is the formation of layer structures. First figure represents the stacking of one monotype planes of the austenitic matrix with the lattice invariances. This stacking turned into the layer structures with the stacking sequences A, B, C, B, C, A, C, A, B, A, and others. This is another illustration of the formation of layer structures in the D-O-3 type unit structures. These are the basic terms and definitions related to the Shapovary effect and crystallographic transformation. Experimental studies were performed, experimental studies were performed in two copper-based Shapovary alloys. These are copper zinc aluminum and copper aluminum manganese alloys. You can see the alloy composition of these alloys, and this composition were selected in the beta phase raging of the material. In this alloys, martensite start and martensite finish temperature is important. As you can see, martensite start and martensite finish temperatures are over the room temperatures, and both of the alloys are completely in the martensite state at the room temperatures. Specimens obtained from these alloys were solution treated for homogenization in the beta phase field, as following then quench in ice bath and aged at room temperatures. These metathizing temperatures are 830 for copper zinc aluminum and 700 degrees for copper aluminum mangan alloys, and these temperatures are in the beta phase region. Powder specimens for X-ray examination were prepared by filling these alloys, and powder specimens were sealed in evacuated to the quartz tubes and given beta phase homogenization treatments to release the external effect. These treatment temperatures are the same. Powder diffractorums were obtained for all the specimens at the different stages of the aging in a long time interval. This is an X-ray diffractorum taken from copper zinc aluminum alloy sample after long-term aging at room temperature for about 15 years after quenching. It is interesting that these peak pairs are important for the copper base shape memory alloys. These pairs are 1-2, 2-2, 1-8, 2-8, 1-10, 2-10, and others. As you can see, peak intensities are different, and this diffractorum exhibits superlattice reflection. This is another X-ray diffractorum taken second alloy sample of copper aluminum mangan after long-term aging at room temperature for about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, this diffractorum also exhibits superlattice reflection with this plane pairs. A series of X-ray diffractorums have been taken from both of the alloy samples in a long time interval, and some changes have been observed in the diffraction angles and diffraction intensities and peak characteristics with age and duration. In particular, some of the successive peak pairs have shifted toward each other. This peak pairs provide the following relation between Miller indices. Here, N is for 418R martensite. As I stated at the diffraction profile, this plane pair can be listed as follow. 418 structure, 1-2, 2-2, 1-8, 2-8, 1-10, 2-10, 2-10, 0-4-0, 3-2-0, and others. At the long-term investigation, it is observed that this peak pairs come close each other with age and duration. And this change refers to the changes in the crystal structure of material. Also, this change refers to the rearrangement of atom in disordered manner. With the basal plane of martensite is subjected to the hexagonal distortion with martensite formation on which atom size have important effect. In case the atoms occupying the lattice size have the same size, the basal plane of martensite becomes regular hexagon. Otherwise, the deviations occur from hexagonal arrangement of the atoms in case of atom size are different. In the disordered case, all of the lattice sites are occupied randomly, and atom size can be taken approximately equal each other. In the ordered case, lattice sites are occupied regularly by certain atoms which have different atomic sizes, and basal plane deviated from regular hexagonal arrangement of atoms due to the atom size differences. This is the basal plane of parent phase. With the martensitic transformation, basal plane turns into this rectangular shape, turn into the hexagonal shape. In the disordered case, we don't know which atom occupied which lattice size, and we can take atomic sizes approximately equal each other, and hexagonal structure becomes normal hexagonal. In the ordered case, atomic distribution is regular, and neighbor atoms sizes are not the same. And in this case, deviations occur from the hexagonal arrangement. Second study is performed in the electron microscopy with electron diffractions. And as you can see, electron diffraction patterns also exhibit superlattice reflection. First figure represents the electron diffraction pattern of copper-zinc aluminium, and second figures belongs to the electron diffraction pattern of the copper aluminium mangan alloy samples. Basic collisions conditions, Shapemaker effect is evaluated by the crystal structural change in microscopic scale by means of martensitic transformations. The fundamental structures of the beta type martensites are orthorhombic closed pocket structures, which consist of an array of closed pocket planes in copper based Shapemaker alloys. The beta type martensites have the layered structures and are characterized by stacking sequences depending on the order in the parent phase. Copper-based ternary alloys have the deuteritized spare lattice in parent austenitic phase and following stacking sequences occur with martensitic transformation. Less sequences are AB, CB, CA, CA, BA, BC, BC, AC, and AB. On the basis of Austin martensitic relation, the basal plane of 9R or 18R martensites originated from one of the 1-1-0 type planes of current on which lattice invariances occur into opposite direction with the martensitic transformations. These are the references. Thank you very much. For your attention. If anybody have a question, I'll try to answer.
Yes. Thank you so much, doctor. Anybody has any questions?
Yeah, please.
Thank you very much, dear professor. Very nice talk.
You are welcome. Doctor, I cannot hear. Yeah.
We are unable to hear your voice.
Yeah, please. Question, please.
Dr. Bayram, can you hear him? Can you hear Dr. Osman?
Yeah, okay.
That's fine, Dr. Usman. I think there is no question from audience.
Sorry, please.
I don't think there is no questions from audience, and then just we can move ahead for the next presentation.
Okay. Can I end the PPT?
Yes. You can stop your presentation. Thank sharing you your much. Slides.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much.
Dr. Justin Nason, can you hear me?
Justin Mason.
Unfortunately,